Can you just mention some of the names, let's say Europe, also, from then, also Denmark to South, also to Italy, or from the United States, just to get
a
feeling?
Well, one of the great inorganic chemists in Europe was Gerold Schwarzenbach in Zurich, Lars Gunnar Selèn in Stockholm, who in fact had invited me already in 1953 to present a lecture there at a meeting, and Jannik Bjerrum in Copenhagen, famous inorganic chemist, of course. One who later received the Nobel Prize was Henry Taube. At that time he still was in Chicago, now he's at Stanford, and Jack Halpern, and many others. So
I understand your place became a mecca for measuring mechanisms of inorganic chemistry with ligands, and later on also with organic compounds.
Yes, let me try to explain it a little more. I said before that a metal ion surrounds itself with two shells of water molecules. And if it combines with a ligand, that ligand has to penetrate through this water shell. And the chemists had following a nomenclature by Ingold, had called an substitution first order or second order as a rate limiting step. First order he would mean that before a ligand can enter the shell, a water molecule leaves. It's a first order reaction. Then the ligand can move in. And the second order means that the ligand first comes in and replaces then a water molecule from the shell. We could clarify many such reactions, and we really got a periodic table of reaction rates. All rates between, for the main group elements, for the alkali, the alkaline earth, the earth metals, for the transition elements, and we really could correlate it with electronic structure. And so this clarified the whole field.